Hi, my name is Kirill Gavriluk, and today I want to talk about love. Love between our planet-scale NoSQL database as a service, DocumentDB, and mobile developers. And today we're using Xamarin. As with all enduring relationships, our love is based on few tangible traits. Azure DocumentDB is a NoSQL database. You can store any data in it. You don't have to define the schema. You don't need to worry about indexes. You get rich queries, fast queries, and you can use a variety of APIs. You can use familiar SQL syntax for queries. You can use JavaScript. You can use Mongo APIs, which we support at the protocol level. Azure DocumentDB is a managed service, so you don't need to worry about VMs and cores. You just need to tell us what throughput do you want, and we scale you, and there are no limits to that. It's a fast database, so your data will be served in less than 10 milliseconds in the same data center. It's a global scale database, which means that you can take your data and we'll replicate it across 38 or more regions across the world so that any user anywhere on the planet of your app can get the data at the same low latency. And DocumentDB offers a number of features that are especially interesting for mobile developers. For example, geospatial queries built in and supported, as well as binary attachments. Let's dive in into the demo. It's easy to get started with DocumentDB. In fact, you don't even need to sign up for Azure. You can download our free emulator and start working with DocumentDB on your local desktop. You don't even have to be connected to the network. But if you happen to have an Azure account, you can create DocumentDB in Azure portal by finding us in the left navigation pane and clicking Add and giving a document your first DocumentDB account a name and telling where you want it to be located. Now, I already created a DocumentDB account. And if you create one at the beginning, we greet you with a quick start to make your day a little better. We have a number of platforms that you can work with DocumentDB from. In our case, we're building a mobile app and we're using Xamarin. DocumentDB stores data in collections. And you can store any types of data, any data structures in the same collection. So let's create, in our quick start, we're going to create an items collection and then download a ready-to-run app that is already pre-configured to talk to your collection. Once you download the app, it's already connected to my app demo account. And as many of the Hello World apps that you've seen of late, it's a to-do list, right? The modern day Hello World, where I can go and add tasks. Okay. And if I go back and look at my Document Explorer, I can see that I need to get milks. Apparently, I need to get multiple types of milk. That's great. Now, as it often happens with mobile apps, we want to ship many versions, one after another. And sometimes we change data with which our app works with. DocumentDB is a NoSQL database, so it doesn't require you to specify a schema, and it makes it very easy to deal with multiple versions. So let me do just that. Let me stop my app and go and modify and add one more property. I want to get organized, and I want my to-do items to have a priority. So let's add a field priority. Let's give it a type int. We want our app to work with the previous data. So in the client, we declare int nullable. And because I want to be super organized, I want my priority to be always one, right? Just like I do in real life. Everything is priority one. Great. So let's launch our app again. And let's give myself a new task. Get bread. And let's take a look what happens at the backend. Notice that we did not change anything in our backend. So let's refresh. And as you can see, we have now our second item. And our second item has the field priority one, while I was the first one, did not have anything. I did not have to touch the backend at all. My app talks directly to the database and stores data structures without caring about schema or indexes, and I still enjoy good, rich queries, and I can change, modify, and can work with 10 versions of my app out there working with the same DocumentDB collection. Now, with that, DocumentDB is a managed service. So I can, when I add my collections, I don't need to worry about cores or VMs. I just need to tell DocumentDB that I want a collection with this initial size of data, and this can grow once you provision your collection, and this amount of throughput. Let's add 250,000 request units. And one request unit is sufficient to perform one read request of 1K document. And once you set this throughput, every operation has certain consumes certain amount of request units, and it's constant through time. One read request consumes one request unit today, tomorrow, until the end of time. This collection allows you to perform 250,000 requests per second. That's a lot. And just like that, with just clicking OK button, I can provision that much capacity. Well, here I have a collection that simulates an IoT scenario where devices are sending us requests at millions of requests per minute. And at the same time, look at the latency. We are offering and serving data with less than 2 millisecond latency, regardless of the ingestion rate. That's another important characteristic of DocumentDB, low latency. So DocumentDB gives you limitless throughput, guarantees with SLA, and offers low latency. And at the same time, you can offer the same low latency around the world. Just by clicking on a map, I can bring my collection in any of the 38 Azure regions, that is ever increasing number, around the world, so that all my users, no matter where they are, enjoy the same low latency. Moreover, I can use the same functionality to offer high availability for my collections so that no matter what happens in a given region, my data is always available at low latency to all of my users. I can schedule failover policies programmatically or manually through this blade. Right here, I have an example of a collection that is distributed across the world. And look, whether it's central US or whether it's Japan, I have the same low latency for reads. Here, we are writing to a single region, so we have low latency in central US for writes, and slightly higher in Japan because we need to cross a continent. There are configurations that enable to you multi-region writes with DocumentDB. I just summarized for you several things that you can do with DocumentDB, but let's do something specific to mobile. Let's open my another app. Here I have another mobile app that gives me the list of earthquakes in any geographical region, in this case, around Seattle. So I just like that, I can enter and specify any polygon. And request earthquakes in this region. And I can see that there are some earthquakes still happening, even in Seattle. But look, on the programming model side, this is all I need to do to query for these earthquakes. We support natively geospatial queries in DocumentDB, including our link provider for .NET. So in your Xamarin application, you can just write quake.location within a polygon, and these methods are already provided to you. You don't need to do your quake and your polygon. They're just geospatial types. You don't need to write any code for this, just these two lines. And you get geospatial queries efficient, get you anything within a very popular mobile scenario within a given georegion, within a given polygon, get me some geospatial data. You just saw, in a nutshell, DocumentDB and how to use it with mobile apps. Do try our samples. Do take a look at our documentation. And just look us up and start playing with it. You don't need to sign up for Azure. Use the Azure DocumentDB emulator. Or if you already have an Azure account, check us out at portal.azure.com.